figure. No one really knows his name for sure. He stands at 6'6", head and shoulders. Pray he never comes knocking at your door. Say that you once bought a heart or new corneas, but somehow never managed to square away your debts. He won't bother to write or to phone you. He'll just rip the still beating heart from your chest! Now you could run, you could hide, you could try to, but he always has a way of finding you. He will come at your weakest hour, when no one is around who might rescue you. And none of us are free from this horror, for many years ago we all fell in debt. New body parts were needed to perfect our image, and until our debts are clear, we will live in fear of the...
Surgery. It's what I need to change.
Mag's contract's got some mighty fine print.
Some mighty fine print?
And that mighty fine print puts Mag in a mighty fine predicament. If Mag up and splits, her eyes are forfeit. And if Gene, Co, and Roddy so will it, then a repo man will come and she'll pay for that surgery. 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 Surgery.
Not the dead doctor with the hungry scalpel. Here's my prognosis. Will they live?
Doubtful.
Eunice Creek Physician, Tommy Glass, Sculptures.
Beat your ass like a rat. You like it out.
Better start praying when you see him coming.
But tonight it's curtains.
You're the night surgeon. Up your half my money.
Oh, it's born beyond you.
He'll do your ass like dishes.
Amputation. Remember who you are.
Every desperate murmur. I remember where I gaze upon her. She looks just like you. I remember. I remember.
I remember loving every victim with acute precision.
I remember every time I hold you, my born companion. And I remember. I dismember. The grave medic is no anesthetic.